How do you explain transient heat conduction? Conduction for an unlocked road, unlocked metal road. Consider the case of using a candle. Sit down. Using a candle flame, as below. You have a candle flame. You have a metal rod. It's of length L. You have wax placed at a distance X. This is X. What would be the time taken for the wax to melt? Time for the wax to melt. What would be the time? First of all, what is observed experimentally is that X is equal to B over L plus C T. That is what is observed for short roads, i.e. L is small, or short. The graph will look like X again this time. It will appear as a straight line graph. L1, L2. L2 is greater than L1. Now, for long roads, the graph will appear as will look like that. X again this time. It will look like X is equal to a constant F 1 minus exponential negative bt. That's what the graph looks like. How do you explain all this stuff? We are going to consider that the metal rod has an isotropic thermal conductivity, thermal conduction. For an isotropism, the flux will equal to K X T dx plus KR T dr for an isotropism. T dr is equal to dt dx. Dx minus dx dr, which is equal to dt dx times dx dv minus dv dr. Q bar will equal to kx plus kr to L over r dt dx. What we are going to do, we are going to assume that the temperature gradient is initially linear, and it is given by T is equal to negative power over K X plus TS. This is TS. S minus T O is equal to P over K L. P is equal to K, okay? S minus T O over L. Therefore, T is equal to negative T S minus T O over L X plus T S T D X is equal to negative T S minus T O over L. Therefore, Q bar is equal to K X plus K R to L over R T S minus T O over L. Therefore, Q is equal to Kx over L plus Kr Kr over R Ts minus To times the area. Now, we're going to say that we are going to call. Now, to explain the above variables, we are going to say that power is equal to Hs theta minus theta and plus Mc dt dt. Now, the thing is this. We are going to consider the heat transfer coefficient not to be varying with temperature. H doesn't vary with temperature. Now, power is a constant and is equal to Q bar. Now, we're going to have power minus Hs T minus Txs equal to mc dt dt. Finally, Hs, okay, T minus T lambda is equal to power 1 minus exponential negative to H over Rs T. Now, S is equal to 2 pi r x. Therefore, H 2 pi r x T minus T lambda is equal to the power is equal to N into K r over R plus Kx over L Ps minus To the 1 minus exponential negative to H over Rs T. The final expression will be X T minus T lambda is equal to R over 2H K This means, for short, when time is big, i.e. L is long, X against time will appear like that. Now, for short rods, the final expression look like X is equal to dk over r plus kx over l ts minus t lambda over t minus t lambda t. In short, the graph will look a straight line graph. X again this time, this is L, L2, L1, where L2 is greater than L1. So X is equal to B over L plus C T. So let's explain what is observed. All the above constants, this TS means the temperature at the beginning of the rod at the hot end. This is the temperature in the melting works of the wax, the melting point of the wax. TS is temperature at hot end. T, melting point of wax. This one is the radio thermal conductivity. This is the axial thermal conductivity. In short, we can assume that what we assumed that H is a constant was indeed true, independent of temperature. Independent of temperature. Okay, thank you. We shall meet next time. Thanks for your time. Good day.